Mapazulara Bishop, William Tagat, episode
4.
4, season 3.
Well,
we're back.
Yeah. Luna, where are we again?
44 Quinn Street, First 15 Brewery.
What are we drinking?
Golden Giraffe.
Golden Giraffe, baby. Guys, we appreciate the love. Please don't stop. Subscribe, like, and keep viewing, all right?
So you don't do the blow kiss.
So let's hate on me when we're
going.
After that intro, I think I should be sitting, but anyway.
Story for another week.
But anyway, guys, yeah. I feel the emotion on my left and on my right for different reasons.
We lost?
Yes.
Usu.
Two are good.
Side.
Usu.
And
do,
the boys.
Do you think the better team won or it was just.
No, look, I think the Haka wasn't
there. They wanted it more.
The Haka wanted it
more. I think our best player, we actually got us to the final.
Yeah.
Actually kept the scoreboard ticking. When we needed him.
The fullback.
Yeah.
Good player. He's great.
Good player.
Yeah.
And future player to watch for.
Yeah, no, he's definitely going to be playing.
Watch out for him.
So I'm Jay Liberty. So you guys go do the Haka at halftime because different team came out in the second half. Yeah. No,
I think Wakona. So I think when they do the Haka in the first half,
they didn't do the Haka because
I know there's issues.
That's so funny, yeah.
It is. Like, for me, it's hilarious.
There's copyright infringement.
Because I was thinking about it when the game started. I was like, yeah, we're talking about this earlier. So I think at halftime they went and did the Haka because they came out.
They were different team, right?
Different team.
So, gents, best game we've watched all year?
Oh yeah.
Definitely.
Brilliant.
Absolutely brilliant. Dude, like,
but also again, James, credit to the CPUT also. Last year they won that tournament last minute. Again, they won it last
year. They wanted it extra time this time.
Lovely.
It's beautiful seeing that the HBC 40 will be on the other side.
Yeah.
Singing. To ECBT, then they'll reply. It's.
But what I like about
good
it.
Good things are happening at Varsity Shield. I'll be watching that from now on.
That was going to be my point to say that it's lifting the whole Varsity Cup thing. Because we're watching Varsity Shield and you're saying, for me, that Varsity Shield thing might even eclipse the Varsity Cup final if we do have a Varsity Cup final, guys.
Yeah.
Well, I think the games are different because like Varsity Cup is very more structured. It's like,
true.
It's like watching Curry Cup or something else.
Balls versus shots.
In Varsity Shield, dude, it's cool wearing. It's like just swing the ball and play.
It's when we just
play somebody and keep it going.
Yeah, I feel like e-letting Varsity
Shield
Cup, it's too coached.
That's very good.
Yeah. It's almost semi-professional. It's almost to the professional level.
They coach the kids out of the game. Whereas they...
In Varsity Shield, just play.
Structured, right? But this...
No, there's little things like kick the ball out of the 22.
Play like old blanks. Fix it up.
Yes, do the Haka.
Yeah.
But anyway, it was fun to watch. Yes.
But, yeah.
Let's talk about the game of the weekend. In your opinion.
Can you park the game of the weekend? In our opinion, the game of the weekend is the Stormers versus Lions. I want to go to the Sharks. I'll come to that. Anyway, Sharks versus Lions, guys. Last week I said Bulls were going to win, but I thought it was going to be a very tight game. But
can I go home now? Yeah, I will talk about
this. What is the score again? 43, what? Nine.
Second half.
So my point was to you, Lunga, that I think the Sharks didn't, after the dressing room, they didn't leave the dressing room. It was 12-9, and it was a very tight first half. First half, could have gone either way. Let's be honest.
So Leon, we've had many of these conversations, and I hate stats in sports, right?
Yeah.
Right. I'll give you a stat. Right? So at halftime, the score is 12-9.
True.
In the 60th minute, the score is 19-9.
Mm.
Yeah.
Right? And then. So at the 80th minute, the score is 43-9. So everything just went sideways in 20 minutes. Hold
on. But what happened to Kaka halftime?
I don't know. Like Sean set the guys down and had a chat with them, and then I think they left the change room, but their souls stayed in the change room. And then we made subs. But look, I can't hate. The Bulls had a plan, and their plan worked. They said, if the Sharks are in the game at halftime, we bring on our Springbok props and we just take the game away from them. Mm-hmm. We maul them to death. We play in tight phases. Osmara, we played Ward off the park in the second half.
Hey, Osmara were playing. Eh? He was running into the park. He was running into angle. Hendricks.
Zola. I think in all of your playing rugby, you've never scored a try as easy as Trevino Jacobs' try.
Mm.
Like when he caught the ball, the guy behind him.
But you know, Lunga, the camera didn't get to where, and I thought there were still defenders coming.
No, you thought there was someone coming.
Yes, and there was no one.
He literally jumped.
The guy looked at, he couldn't believe that he scored the try. And then he was like, yeah. But one thing is, the Bulls are going back to that 2007, 2008, 2009, 2010.
You know, the Bulls have never left. They've never left that rugby. They just have the squad.
Now so what happens? What happens?
Lizo Kobota and Trevor Nyan.
What happened in the second half? For me personally, we changed front rows.
Yeah.
Well, at halftime, the Lions, the Bulls changed their front row. Right.
Mm-hmm.
And then the Sharks, as per the team strategy, took off Thomas and took off Ox. But so we take off Thomas and we take off Ox and bring on Vian Herbst.
Yeah.
Okay. A journeyman prop against Trevor. We take off Thomas and bring on Dutsuko
Mtunu. So it's not a fitness issue.
No. We take off Ox to take off Thomas and bring on Dutsuko Mtunu, who was playing eighth man a year ago. Right? Yeah. So he's learning the position.
Yes, but he's gonna be a talent.
But he's a talent, but he's not a prospect. Like, he's still learning the position.
I'm a fan.
The Bulls' front row changes completely change the game. Because now all of a sudden their pack is going forward. Lizo's going to try. They had a rolling mall try.
Yep.
And all the other tries were from a situation where sustained possession, you suck the defense, and then you swing the ball wide. It wasn't anything spectacular.
Guys, it's not special playing rugby. We play eight forwards going forward.
So now we're going to try Chris Smith, the body point try. When they literally looped the ball over the last defender, there was four guys waiting for that.
True. So all you do is just sucking in defenders. We're sucking in defenders.
So the second best team in the country gets beaten by at least 30 points?
Yeah.
And to be honest, when the game started, they were the number one. The Sharks were on points.
Are they 40 points better than the rest of the...
I don't think the Sharks are that... The scoreline does not say who the Sharks really are. It's just that they didn't pitch up in the second half.
I'll be curious. I'm not going to defend that performance because it was atrocious. Like, I mean, I know as a Sharks fan, I know. when they were literally like chasing the bonus point.
Yeah.
Because it's nice to see a team go after.
Yeah.
Because a lot of times you get the scoreboard, ass is good.
Yeah.
But they literally decided, the Bulls didn't have a bonus point this whole season. This is round three. They didn't have a bonus point.
Yeah.
Until yesterday.
Yeah.
But when they actively chased it, I was like, this is tickets.
Yeah.
So like, I'm curious to see what that game would look like in Durban.
Very true.
If the weather doesn't play a factor in it, because you always use the altitude excuse. We played the Stormers, we played at home, and then we came up to Joburg, and then the second half, I don't know.
So you need good forwards and a 12. Is that what you need?
No, I need
better forwards
and a 12.
No, Lunga, can I come
to his answer? Please.
Can I come
let to the Bulls fan defend?
Yeah, can
let
I come to his defense? So I don't think he needs better forwards. He needs a backup. So what happened with the Bulls is that Bulls had average per se props that were, these lighties are coming from under 21 structures. What they did is they bring in Springboks. So when I saw my props, I'm like, why is Trevor? But then the genius in our coach,
okay, Raga.
Jake White says, listen, I'm going to sit these two. And as Lunga said, at halftime, if the game is close, we're going to bring on experience. What they did is that you've got Ox and you've got the tank, Springboks. Ox is not yet a Springbok, but he will be. The tank is a Springbok. Now, when you replace that, you've got to bring on another Springbok. You can't have inexperienced guys. That Lighty Waka, who used to play eighth man, he's going to be a beast. Yeah, in the next 2 years. But he's not a beast now. Now you're scrumming against Utreva, no, he's a tough boy. Yes, Utreva. So you've got talent versus
depth.
Depth.
Yeah.
And depth wins all the time. Your talent can only take you so far. But now we've got people who are like, listen, I've been in this.
But also, again, those Springboks that were there first half,
yeah,
if they were just not there just to manage the game, because go and did what? Just
no doubt. No doubt.
But at least, like, it's the same thing that happened,
yeah,
against inexperienced props.
Yeah.
Demolish.
Absolutely.
First half, Thomas,
we're dominating.
Should have demolished them.
Again, not locks.
What do you mean, not locks?
But they've got locks. You know what happened? It was just game management in the first half. It was just game management for the Bulls to say, listen, we're going to game management this thing to see if it's tight.
He's got a player on the outside. He looks up. He looks one notch. He's up.
But Dwayne now has Eskom covering him. So he goes, boom. If he makes the tackle, Eskom is here. You see what I'm saying? I'm going to come to another point.
You make a good point to that. And I can't take that away. The Sharks should have probably been in the ascendancy come halftime.
True.
If that's your starting eight
Yeah.
against the Bulls, B team front row.
True.
You really should be a good 12 or 15 points cleared off time so you can manage the game. But it's a four dominated game in the half court. You bring on a substandard front row and they bring on the 18. The dynamics are always going to change. True. One of us forget, and I can't say anything bad. I must forget, and it was what it was.
Yeah. Because they're tough, and then brand new eight.
And then Usman Wagalunga was just running line second off.
No, Usman is literally playing behind the advantage line. Where do you see a 12 live behind the advantage line and still have a super game?
Dude.
Because in South African rugby, and in most rugby, your 12 is your ball carrier taking over the advantage line.
You guys ever talk about Mone?
Mone scored all the points. He had a good game. He didn't even miss one with Mone. The team.
Yeah, what did you say last week? What did you say last week?
What did you say last week?
He's also singing Simply the Best after.
Simply the Best. So I heard a comment that they need to change the leaf link from Derek Ocha to him, bro. It's done. I'm changing the
leaf. You can't change it now. Listen, it's 36.
If I was playing 10 with that pack, I'll also score.
You score all the points.
I'll score all the points.
So, like, can I be honest with you? The pack didn't even need a 10. I'd put on Nohamba at 10 and he'd still do well for the Bulls. I'm just saying. I'm being extra. But look, all I'm saying
I felt sorry for a guy like Libok coming
up. Jeez. So, but did you see the Libok? And I'm not a Libok.
He really wanted to prove a point.
He came on to play.
He almost got that try and then.
Yeah.
But anyway,
he knocked it on. No, it's good. Look. There's a lot of substance to the fact that the Bulls are number one. They showed it yesterday, and we've got to own that. Like, it's just easier that way.
True.
I'm not going to lie and make excuses for the Sharks because they were terrible. Like,
they didn't.
I mean, Zanga Luto. Like, you can't not score points in a whole half of rugby.
No.
I can't remember correctly, but I think they were in the 22 after the whole second. I can only remember them once, and they had a lineup, and they overthrew it, and the Bulls took the ball back and scored a try.
Lunga, we stole a couple of lines, but I want to ask you guys something. So there's a contentious issue. Gus 6-7. There's a 6 who's a Bok captain, and there's a 6 who's thinking. Is our captain the best 6
in the country?
In the country,
actively
based on the performances somehow behind, and I'm talking both games, by the way.
Are you making a direct comparison to the 6 that played yesterday against each other, or are you saying in general?
In general.
Yeah, but the other one has been playing. Bro, he's been playing. Bro.
Esco, he's been playing.
Yeah. But he's been playing the whole year.
I see a
play goal last week.
And
yesterday also
he made the second or third most tackles yesterday.
He was busy.
Yawn.
And it's here in your team.
Dude,
I'm just asking the question because what I saw.
The answer to the question is no. CA is not the best six.
No, yeah, he knows. He said it himself. I'll be stupid to think that I can walk into that Springbok.
But he doesn't know.
He's the captain. He's a South African loose forward.
Yeah,
but he's gonna build himself into at least now for the first time in. So he's playing to the ball. He's actually busy. He's actually getting involved.
Guys, I saw him a lot yesterday. Yeah, to be honest, more than I've seen him when he was still playing.
I would not have a very fit CA Kolisi.
In July. Because we need him to be fit because he has to start. He is our captain.
He's a leader.
So I hate it when what is happening in the World Cup and CA gets 60 minutes.
Yeah.
Like, it just diminishes a lot for me to say you're the leader of the team, but you're only good enough until a certain point. Then we can win without you.
You remember he was still injured there.
No, but that's what I'm saying. It was when Prince Lemaiti. You need a fit CA who can give you 80 minutes so we can stop talking trash about the fact that CA is not really the captain of the team. Because then CA has to play 80 minutes because we had to wrap him in cotton wool for the World Cup because we needed him there.
True.
Right?
He's our leader.
So we won the World Cup, so let him be out there. Let him play. Yeah. Let him show up.
Yeah.
So you can fill your statue all you want, tackles, meters, all that unnecessary stuff. But I want CA to play 80 minutes and I want CA to show up in those 80 minutes. So even if I know he's the second best or third or fourth best six in the country,
he's still
the captain of the Springboks because that's the role.
He's a leadership.
That's the role. When John Smith had to move to prop, we knew.
I just put him as our captain. I want to ask you guys something.
There's MJ Pelser.
I know.
There's Mone van der Spot van Staden. There's that kid that played in the Storm of Zutaba. He showed up. Even the Tennyson yesterday had a super game.
The Lions
exhale. They didn't do anything stupid.
Stupid.
Made his tackle.
He did his job.
Long on your point. So you stand.
Talk about our game.
Hold on, I'm going to get to that point. I just want to quickly finish this flank discussion. if he's still our leader and we have a six, like, for me, Eskom. Eskom deserves a call up. Do I not replace the other 50th, 60th minute? Because I have to give Eskom.
Yeah, but look.
But you see, but look, how you do it
also,
everything?
Look, also again, like, we blessed in this country have, like.
We were the loose forward factory.
Besides that, you have at least like four leaders in one pack.
In the squad.
In one pack. So if I tell you, like, just give me 40 minutes of your life.
Yeah. I'll give you the best 14 minutes.
And trust this, the person that's going to take it. And then whoever's going to take over leadership, we continue. Because I don't think it would be unfair for us to sit in 80 minutes.
Are you talking for the Springboks? Because the Sharks have played him three games, 80 minutes.
Red Bull. But yeah, I hate. Hey, but here's my thing.
Yeah.
There's a lot of ways we can shuffle or see a situation and get 80 minutes out of it.
Yeah.
Because if you're gonna game manage your players, then it's easy. You start Sia, you play Dwayne at 8.
Yeah.
Dwayne must give you 60.
Yeah, because he's also
a grown man.
I was coming to that point.
So when you take Dwayne off, you move Sia to 8, and then for starting can get his time. But
interesting.
But that's what I'm saying. The same example I made with you, when no one questioned it when John Smith was scrumming a prop for the last 15 minutes of a test match.
Yeah.
Because he could not leave Bismarck on the bench.
Yeah, yeah.
Bismarck was the best worker in the world at the time.
Yeah.
But he couldn't start because
John Smith is our leader.
Skipper is a skipper, right?
Yeah.
But you make provisions to keep the team going forward.
Okay, I hear you. So I want to go to the game of the weekend. Jeez.
So
I thought smash and grabs happened only
smash and
grabs for Joburg team.
Smash and grabs.
One hell of a smash and grab. Boy.
Great game. Great game, though.
Great game.
Freaking awesome game.
James, for me, that was
Who made the game nice? It was the Lions. James.
Guys played out of their skins.
Felt like it was back in 2010 when a young Elton jumped on Eddie Clark. Did you see that, Jordan?
Hendrickson was a present.
Yeah.
No, Hendrickson. I was like,
I'm back in 2010 when a 19-year-old
another thing we must say is that depth and talent thing. I've been trashing Dan Creel and I feel so vindicated because Berger made a huge difference.
Leadership
like, wise, that leadership,
leadership
that, calming, in, that yeah. calming influence, leadership that take the ball to the line.
I've been trashing Gordon Dow, but he came through.
But then also, Berger also played with a different team.
But that's what I'm saying.
He was the leader.
He made it.
Creel was the leader for the past 2 weeks, you remember?
Yes,
but he couldn't lead
Zeeling.
Yeah. And then Gordon Dow comes over. Guys, that game was the Lions to win.
I'm pretty sure I'm happy with the coaching.
I'm very sad that the Lions.
So he came through and said, but this is just
switch. So it's the break.
I still have an issue with that try, Legacy Milan.
Although Legacy Milan, because
I still think, I don't know if there was an advantage given there because they stole the ball and tried to pass it.
Yeah.
And then he tipped it and scored.
Yeah.
Later Hendricks was a forward pass.
But also a lock trying to do
it. Trying to do a double skip pass. And the best thing is, passing to Pretorius.
Yeah.
And then Rikosu pass.
There was like a former, our EP who was a prop. Okay. Yeah, I'm not going to make it to next week.
Bjorn won't be here next week. So obviously.
The EP is going to fire me. But guys, that was a good advert for South African rugby.
Yeah.
Not the second game.
That scares me. And we've been saying this about the stories.
You know, they are strong and big, but
I don't rate him.
Jeez.
Maybe I'll retract this in the next season.
No, he will retract it in the next season.
I say bad things about Vincent once upon a time.
And now
you're taking them back. I don't know about him, man. I don't see what he adds. All I'm saying is Klavakanya is going to be a force to reckon with. Probably.
Yeah.
That boy is something special.
Mm-hmm.
Steve showed up against my hammer of all people.
What a chance.
Our Pat Spencer.
That's
Pat Spencer.
The whole reason why they were in front.
Yeah.
Because what they those props for the Lions.
Yeah, yeah.
They held us in and they dominated.
They dominated you guys.
And then all of a sudden, we looked like a young under 19 side against.
But I still want to ask you that you guys, you know, I had a comment from the Peanut Gallery that you guys don't have killers. as much as your team on paper should have thrashed the Lions. Thrashed. I'm talking thrashed, Zola. Not just win at the 81st minute. Do you agree that you guys don't have killers?
I mean, that's a reckless statement.
I'm saying it. I heard it from Peter. What does that mean?
Amateur hour.
It's the best way to describe it.
Yeah, obviously, what's the night gone?
4 weeks.
I think it's very harsh. Got a toll 2 weeks at least. Yeah, but anyway, we can't argue with
it. Yes, gone. We need better centers.
And then your Willemse, 50?
Yeah, I still think he's in high school and trying to do.
Still playing a ball.
Yeah, but
we lost this weekend.
My thing is, so now with Willemse, you're moving from 10 to 15. He won't make mark, bro.
Yeah, also.
Weekend special is knocking on the door.
The week before, they kept on kicking on him.
Yeah.
And he caught almost every ball.
Yeah.
But this week.
Even this week, he caught one.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then it turned into a try.
Yeah, that one. That,
yeah. But the one he gave to you was 2-11.
Yeah. Most of them he missed. Like, I wasn't comfortable when they kicked down
the throat.
Yeah. I was.
So, why are you worried then? So, my thing is, this guy is the 10 for you guys that you guys started. When you signed his contract, Nala number 10. Now we're moving to 15.
No, they signed the talent. They didn't sign the flower.
No, I hear you, Lunga. We've been watching
from our first time.
What you say? Why? What's going on?
Jacques and all of them.
It's like, in the Western Cape. Yeah.
Yeah. But it's no one saying that don't play Paul Rose rugby. We're in professional era now.
Ebner is good.
Upo Haaland.
Haaland is still injured, by the way. Yeah. When Haaland comes back, is he still going to make it? Because Haaland is a 15 yellow as well. What's going to happen to Willemse? He can't move to 10 because your 10s now are.
We defeated there because the kid is.
That likes he's injured. Yeah.
Injured.
Yeah.
And Ebner. Yeah. Yeah.
But so when where does
first that on the road, sir. Bro.
But Zola, where does he
win? What time should I know you guys are going to win?
Yeah. Okay,
and cool. What time should I know you guys are going to win?
Gents,
I didn't expect the game I saw.
Yeah.
Because you actually
still winning.
No way.
Are you guys playing the Sharks actually in the
second win?
Before I ask for a wrap up on that, I just want to find out, Jess. So the weekend I saw Trans-Tasmanian tournament. It's New Zealand teams versus Australian teams. What's going on there, boys?
It's an ego boost for New Zealand.
Trans 50 Tas. Okay, everybody.
It's an ego boost for New Zealand rugby. So like they were sitting there in the are you going? That's so how can we
maximize more money?
Get some TV revenue and make the players feel better. I say that man. Like the blues have been average all of ACL when they go for 50.
Oh.
Like really.
But how's the Reds who are the champions in Australia and then they lose to that margin? For me, that doesn't make sense.
Yeah, you heard what we said.
Yeah, no, so they put 50.
No. Yeah, you heard what we said. How do we boost our ego? Let's go there.
How do you get your...
Let's go there. So you bring your Aussie Super Rugby champions and they catch a hiding.
They caught a proper hiding. Over 40 points.
Because that's it.
Nah, I think James is...
Oh, wait. I've got something for you. So, captain's challenges. We're back at this. I think we should have a captain's challenge watch as well. Because Berger tried one. To save the game.
You lost one?
He lost one.
And then he tried to save the game and the ref was like, no, there is no more challenges. And he said, but it's the last 5 minutes. And he's like, no, listen to me. You don't have another challenge.
Yeah. Even though it's the last 5 minutes.
Because now they're saying last week, so you watch two games that we're going to watch every week for the next 3 weeks. There was 39 minutes of stoppage time based on captain's challenges.
39.
So that's a half. How many minutes?
39.
I didn't get that?
39.
That's a half.
So we watched two games.
Yeah.
So there's four halves. There was a full half of rugby in those two games. That was captain's challenge. But there was no rugby happening.
Jeez.
Like, Spears play big screen.
Consistency, Jess.
I
was so worried about consistency.
Guys, I agree with you. Because sometimes they have to go. Sorry, Zed. Sometimes they have to go back to like three or four plays. Where it happened and the guy says, listen, I got hit. But then it keeps going. Now the ref has to find out. That guy brings back my point.
Jake on Tuesday complains about it.
Yeah.
See, I figure suddenly.
Yeah.
The very same tackle, Engelbrecht, the first week.
Mm. It's just.
They don't give it on me, and he's. No malicious play.
Did you call it?
Yeah! And he lost the challenge!
John, it's exactly how it happened in the first week.
And then Jake said something about, hey, I'm not too sure about these captain challenges. How?
Is it the same when we're talking about the battle? You hit here and it goes up.
It goes up and but
this thing doesn't make any sense.
Possibly. Because we could have gotten a penalty and then
And you guys were had an easier win than you did Kasmash.
And that ref actually had a good game.
Yeah, no, sure.
And that ref actually had a good game.
You were so excited to call that call. No, you kick from the dead ball area. He's not happy to
he's showing you that he's walking. He's watching everything. I don't know, but the captain challenges, they need to tweak it. They need to tweak it. It's costing us time because now.
So I want to ask you this. I was going to touch on that quick. I know. I have to.
Like, listen. How does it work?
Well, tell the ref.
So, look, I want to ask you this. You want to tweak it. If we are tweaking it, how do we make rugby better? Because, as you said, it takes 39 minutes, James. That's too much time. And this is between the two games, right?
Hmm.
How do we tweak it? How do we make it bigger? Because I saw these players calling for any little thing. If I feel something is hitting me, call captain's channel. How do we make it better? Because the players they're rugby players. We're not soccer. We're not soccer players.
It should happen in certain areas.
Yeah.
Closer to the try line or to the try line, then you can call it.
Yeah.
It's either you're going to get a penalty, yellow card, or a try.
Okay.
But Abba.
On the halfway line.
No.
It helps nobody. Right?
No. It's just a penalty.
So, and I love how now players. I honestly feel like this captain challenge is becoming a bit of a problem because now everyone seems to have a voice.
Yeah.
Like, only the captain should be saying something. Now the captain's getting told, humble to Leo, look at.
Yeah.
And I can't stand that. It's neither like the ref. Are you sure it's not a yellow? The ref's like, no.
Man, listen, let's move on.
Because now we're challenging unnecessary things. Like, if the ref goes, okay, I'll look, the penalty, moving on. No, but ref, I think they should. I don't care what you think.
Just before I move on, so did you see Herschel getting smashed? I'm sorry for all this. Herschel is number 9. See, but you saw it, right?
No, but you see, right?
You guys saw it.
Like, why does this come up running away from the ball? Bear. Like, they passed him and he ran towards the touchdown.
Guys,
and the ball's going this way.
Guys, for me, that's the show. But anyway, boys.
Well done on your win.
Oh, thank you. Well done on yours.
Oh, yeah.
Well done on yours.
Almost like that. I'm done now.
So, guys, again last week, I want to wrap it up. Like, last week, I had predictions. Stormers are playing Sharks in Durban.
Stormers
Lions are playing Bulls.
Stormers by 8, actually.
Okay. Lunga?
No, you did an other game.
Lions versus Bulls. This is at Emirates Park, by the way. We're probably going to rest our Springboks this time. Probably.
Job done.
Yeah, okay. What are you saying? Lions?
I want the Lions to win, but they should have to go with Bulls 4.
Okay, cool.
Bulls 4.
Shark, let's start with your home game.
Our home game, Sharks by 10.
Oof. Jeez. It's a window shark.
I'm hurt, man. I'm hurt. My soul is messed up.
Yeah, and Lions
and Bulls. Emirates Park. Bulls by 10.
Okay.
I'll be Switzerland to call everything by 10.
I have Sharks by 3, Bulls by 20.
That's our sport. Against the Stormers.
Guys, please continue watching. You remember where we at it?
44
Queen Street. Giraffe Beer.
Gonzalez Central.
Yep. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and keep watching. Thank you for a great show, boys.